And so the battle has begun again.
Both the teams and the crowd are all keyed up for this thrilling struggle.
The only way that we're going to win the Stanley Cup is if we play as a unit.
The nervous energy in this building could power a 747.
It was a war.
By Ted Lindsay, I hated every guy I played against.
The Jet Hockey team never stopped until the last bell went.
The thrills, the intensity.
This can be a long, long series.
Worked so hard and fought so long to get here.
The pressure, you think you can't handle it, and then all of a sudden you thrive on it.
It just comes down to the will to win.
There's a lot of sleepless nights because you're thinking about it.
I think we were scared as hell, Dick.
You scored it while playing on a broken leg.
Look at the bill! Oh my heavens! Oh baby!
Tonight is the hour of decision.
And one other thing I'd like to tell you. You've seen the papers, you've been reading them. Well, there's only one way to prove they can't push you around. Let's go out there and knock hell out of them.
All right, Jack, come on now. Let's go.
That means overtime.
Sudden death.
It doesn't matter where you are, the second you pull it out of the box, people come out of the woodwork. It's just an amazing thing. It's been in every province and every territory here in Canada. We've even taken it ice fishing, actually right here on this lake with Mike Richards.
It would have been nice to catch one the same size as a cup and compare trophies.
We call it the People's Trophy. People are allowed to come up, put their arms around it, give it a kiss. People are just attracted to it. It's a really amazing thing to see. The Stanley Cup actually transcends the sport.
Yeah!
Greetings, everyone, with Eddie Olczyk. Ray Ferraro coming up in just a moment. I'm Mike Emmerich. We have reached a game four. You're away from home. You're down in the series 2-1. What do you tell your team?
We win this one. We can make it a best of three. We have home ice. Let's worry about what we do. Don't worry about what might happen if you don't find a way at winning the hockey game. Give yourself a chance. Let's tie it up, and let's get back home and make it a best of three. Pittsburgh's got to find a way to extend this series because, as we've seen in the past, going down 3-1 is not the recipe for success. Win this game, you got a serious chance to win this series.
Aggressive start energized the red and black, and they were rewarded early and often. They score! Derek Brassard! 3-0 Ottawa! Here they come again. Scores! Wraparound backspin! 4-0 Ottawa! Four goals in the first 13 minutes blitz the Penguins and their goaltender. Now trailing 2-1, does a hint of doubt hang over the defending champs? Will they find their game or witness more fireworks in Canada's capital? It's Game 4, Eastern Conference Final, next. From Canadian Tire Center near Ottawa, it's the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Geico. Eastern Conference Final Game 4. The Ottawa Senators host the defending champion Pittsburgh Penguins and lead them in the best of 7-1. Good evening, everyone. Thanks to John Forslund for the wonderful work he did in the first three games. Eddie Olczyk is in Maryland because of the Preakness coming up tomorrow. Pierre McGuire in just a moment. I'm Mike Emmerich. It is the start of a holiday weekend here. It is Victoria Day. It goes through Monday. They are celebrating a little more than that. They're hoping to yell their team to a 3-1 series lead over the Pittsburgh Penguins, the defending champs. Pittsburgh determined to make this even when they go back to Pittsburgh for Sunday afternoon. What'll happen on all this? Don't know, but it'll be fun getting there. And to usher us along the way inside the glass, it's Pierre McGuire. A decision in goal. It's Matt Murray for the Penguins. Your thoughts, Pierre?
Doc, when you and I had a chance to visit with him yesterday, he said he was ready, willing, able, and 100% energized to take on this responsibility. The thing for the Pittsburgh Penguins, they better get some energy from their offense. Sure, they're going to be good in goal, and I believe Murray can deliver, but they need offense, so they need a history lesson. Go back to what they did in round two against Washington. Strong in the boards, quick shots on goal, nothing fancy. And if they did get fancy, they didn't waste time by getting extra fancy. They got pucks to the net. That is so critically important. They passed up a ton of opportunities, so the slickness is great, the finish is good, but do not pass up opportunities, as Jake Guentzel bears witness in round number two against Washington.
This is all 60.
Go ahead, Doc.
No, I apologize. It takes 16 wins to get the Stanley Cup, and the Senators are at 10. Pick a reason why they've gotten there.
Because it's almost impossible to get to the front of their net. They make it hard on anybody, and especially against Pittsburgh's smaller forwards. You take a look at this. I mean, the pictures do not lie. Everything is keeping people away. The Pittsburgh Penguins are having a difficult time getting bodies there, getting pucks through. It's stick positioning. It's body positioning. It's star players like Carlson. It's role players like Hoffman. It doesn't matter. It's equal opportunity, and that's the biggest problem. Pittsburgh's got to find a way to sledgehammer to the front of the net and create chances.
I'm an anxious guy. One team counts on the goalie that only lets in one a game and the defenseman who never comes off. To make it a 2-2 tie, the other goes with the franchise face and the man in the mask of past glories. By Honda, official vehicle of the National Hockey League. And by SAP. Visit NHL.com/stats with live insights from SAP. The anthems, the goalies, and face-off number one next.
Fireworks here in Canada's capital.
Rise up, you got to say rise up, you got to say rise up, I got to say rise up.
Tirez chapeau et casquette, et joignez-vous à Chris Jane pour l'interprétation des hymnes nationaux.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light that so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land.
Registers wonderfully, doesn't it? The performance of the two anthems. The Honda starting goalie. Penguins coach Mike Sullivan had a choice to make. Matt Murray got in for the last 47 minutes of game three, stopped 19 of 20 Senators shots, a Stanley Cup and 15 wins a year ago, injured most of the first two rounds. Craig Anderson will be 36 on Sunday. In this series, he stopped 80 of 83. Of his 10 wins this playoff, six have come in overtime. For Ottawa, Alex Burrows, injured last game, replaced in the lineup tonight by Tommy Wingles at forward. For the Penguins, Josh Archibald gets to make his Stanley Cup debut. The Penguins go with six defensemen. Mark Streit comes out. But interestingly enough, the Penguins have decided to go with a heavy hitter on all four lines. And for that reason, Sidney Crosby.
We're about to begin. Sidney Crosby has won everything possible in the game of hockey. Now he'll see if he can win this faceoff. He's on the ice to put on another show in front of these fans.
Off that right side, he's got a perfect pass. Slides it to the point to Carlson. Skill play by Crosby. Onside. He's in! Brilliant save by Anderson. Let's it go. Deflected off the blocker. That hit somebody. Got in front of another one.
A missed opportunity from this close in.
The Senators with possession up the wing. Let's it go. That one blocked. Pass attempt to Kessel. The Penguins lug that along up the wing. Scooped up by Hornquist. Great glove save.
Now that's a quick glove.
All is halted for now. Time for Ray.
Ottawa's top players took the morning skate off as they rested here, looking for a 3-1 lead in the conference final series tonight.
Over 4 minutes have gone off the clock. It is tied at Cobb. Pitching this one, a terrific shot, but it's answered by the pad. Snaps a shot. Snapped it off. Skill play. Good chance here, but a terrific pad save. He scores!
Haglund's decision was pretty easy. This low in a slot. Just snap it off, and he did.
Anderson's presenting himself pretty largely here. However, there's still room for the puck to beat him.
Some shots, only one goal.
A lot of opportunities. Love the mindset of getting pucks and people to the net.
And that's a face-off win.
Number 62, Carl Hagelin, assisted.
Taken over again. Finessed to Hagelin. Wonderful save. It didn't look like he had a thing to shoot at.
Terrific stop from right in front of the net, but you got to find a way to put the puck in the net.
Possession established on the pickup. Cut his glove on it. The Penguins leave their own end. On to Daly. Gains the zone and looks over his options. The breakaway. Outstanding save by Anderson.
Anderson's athleticism was tested on that wrist shot. That was an excellent scoring chance.
The Penguins win it. Sends to the point. Two sticks together, they cancel. Nicely into the zone. One-timer. Oh, that one hit someone on the way. Back near the blue line to Pageau. Takes a shot. And another strong save. The Penguins up the wing are moving the puck. And he's all alone. Wonderful stop by Anderson. Laid on to Strite. Puck picked up here. Picks up and a great save at the edge of the crease.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
He's got that pass. Pointed to Strite. Big drive, gloved. Gets play stopped.
Man, he leaned into that one, guys. I can see the stick flex. He's really on top of this shot, but the goaltender makes an excellent save.
Just over 8 minutes remaining in the first. Only one goal hanging on the board so far. So it's 1-0. Beat him on that one. Oh, deflected away. A cover, and play is stopped. Solid, clean win. He covers and holds on. Nice face-off work. Slides it to the point to Letang. Just a backhand. That hit somebody. Fanoff's tripped up. That should be a penalty. Crosby's going to the box, and the call is tripping.
This is an easy call for the official, Doc. Player made no attempt to play the puck and just tripped up the attacking player.
And so begins power play number one. Let's see if it's power play goal number one. Ottawa's got that face-off win. The Penguins in their own end, ready in attack.
5 seconds.
Turned a shot on net. Good save there. Gets in, looks over his options here. Backhander to the net. Shot didn't have a lot on it, did it? Directing that one to Cullen. Good defensive play, hand to eye and center ice. A shot. Oh, great save there. Not much room to work, but he got a good shot away.
You talk about cutting down the angle. Perfectly executed by the goaltender.
Chip to Stone. The stick can break up a play, and it just did. With a blast! Shoots right in that catching glove. Good work. The Penguins have killed it off. Passing one off now to Crosby. Shoots one. Perfect save. He covers, and a faceoff will follow.
Anderson's bailed his team out again. That's another odd man rush against. He bails him out.
Pittsburgh's got another win. Receives that pass from the other side. He caught it and he holds on.
Ottawa's fans sitting behind their net got up and showed their respect by bowing to him after that huge save.
Quick work on the faceoff. A shot. He scores! Evgeny Malkin!
That puck looked like it got deflected right in front of the goaltender. I'm sure Ray had a much better look at that.
It did get deflected, Eddie, and when we get a look at it on the replay right here, you're going to see the goalie's in position, but because the puck is deflected the way it was, it gets past him in a way he just can't react to.
The Senators control at center ice, looking to win goals. Back near the blue line to Mathot. Really good deflection. No harm. Carried to the corner boards by Paggio. Back and forth they go between the points. That's terrific work with the pad. Into the end of attack. Shoots one. And a point blank save.
You don't get many better opportunities than that. Great save.
Nearing the last minute of play in the first. Ottawa's in their own end, lugging it along. 52 seconds to play. Waits with it, looking for options. He's alone. Oh, tremendous stop by Anderson.
Sometimes there's just nowhere to go with the puck. Guys, this is an excellent shot, but the goaltender makes an excellent pad save.
The Senators with a face-off win. The Senators have it up the wing. Slid to Stone. Shoots. Outstanding save. Difficult opportunity.
The Penguins are not concerned about their goaltending. A couple of real good stops, but none better than that. What a save early in this game.
Pittsburgh's got a defensive zone win. 20 minutes in the books, and the coaches are paid to do something in the intermissions, too. Let's see if they make a change in this game. Right now, we are done with one. Pittsburgh struck twice. 2-0. A look at the shots on goal. They're pretty overwhelming. 21 for Pittsburgh and 9 for the Senators. The Penguins have a two-goal lead, and the one that made it two was this one. We'll be right back. To enter the second period here.
What did you think of the opening period of our game?
Ottawa's lucky to still be in this game after the first period. They had turnover after turnover. I'm sure the coaches addressed that problem in the intermission.
Shoots one, sticked away. Letang's got it in the defensive zone, headed to center. Nice poke check by Phil Kessel. Has it in his own end. Moving it to Stone. He's in on an onside play. Right from the slot. They score! It's only a one-goal game now.
That's the shot there, Enzo. Low to the stick side. The goaltender can't get to it.
The Senators are only one goal behind, so they've gotten themselves back into this game. Perhaps they can tie it before the end of the second. Pittsburgh's got another faceoff win.
By number nine.
Hatchett's one. Let's it go. And the loose puck captured by Hornquist. Looking for options. Collected now.
1:42.
It's an onside play. Got it in his own end. Pitching it to Hagelin. What a ripper. Oh, a save. And he'll hold on. A little under 4 minutes play. Pittsburgh's given up a goal. Still have a margin, though. And that margin is one. Ottawa's prevailed on another faceoff. Close call under him. Play stopped.
Ryan's played so well for the last little while. His point streak is stretched out again. Guys, you've been talking about him all night, and we've seen why he's been such a prolific performer.
They win it. Fires! Score! What a quick answer that was!
When you're an offensive player and you have that much time, you're allowed to take that big, heavy slap shot. Fortunately for the offensive team, they're rewarded with a big goal.
Anderson's not happy he's given up this goal on the low glove side. Goalies hate giving up goals. When they're in their butterfly, they think they're in position. They've got to have their hands in the right spot to make this stop.
Pittsburgh's prevailed again on the faceoff of the neutral zone.
By number 71, Evgeny Malkin.
And the puck gathered in by Evgeny Malkin.
11 seconds.
A ripper from the point. Ottawa's in possession and moving up the wing. Carried to the corner by MacArthur. Shoot. Not through. Into the attacking end. Big chance! What a save by Anderson! Smart recovery by Brassard. And now it's directed to MacArthur. And possession has changed. Brilliant move on that pass. The Penguins are out of their own end. Knocked right off the stick. Ottawa's controlling the play in their own end. Puck is thrown to Burrows. Good work with the stick. Puck now possessed by MacArthur. Decides to head for the corner. Terrific challenge. Outstanding save.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area. You got to find a way to put it in the net.
Ottawa's carrying it in their own end. Carries it up the wing. In the defensive zone, continuing on. Okay, so he's got it on his stick. What'll he do next? Let's a shot fly. Paddled aside. Propelled to Bonino. The Senators carry through center. Gains the blue line. On to Pageau. Cursed by a broken stick.
I know the goaltender's relieved, Doc, that he broke his stick with that shot attempt.
Hammered! He scores! That's two unanswered goals.
Foligno's ability to be able to shoot the puck that hard and put it where he wants is amazing.
Anderson's not made much available for the shooter, but the area he did up over his stick side shoulder has been exposed.
The Penguins have a big advantage in time of possession, and it shows in the score. Pittsburgh's collected another victory on the faceoff.
Assisted by number four. Time of the goal.
Using the point. With a drive. Just missed the net with that one. A shot. He scores! Crosby!
When you're in the low slot and a puck's on the backhand, you got to react quickly.
Anderson's not able to get his glove on that. It beats him low to the glove side.
The Penguins have added to their overwhelming score, and they continue to have the puck most of the time. Pittsburgh's got another faceoff win. Laid on to Torres. And he picks it up. Snapping a pass to Hornquist.
12 minutes, 30.
Big chance here. He scores. Four unanswered goals.
Hornquist, quick read of the play, allowed him to get that breakaway and score.
Anderson's down in his butterfly a little early. That opens up the top of the net, and he gets beaten cleanly.
The Penguins have a big advantage in time of possession, and it shows in the score. Solid win at center ice. Now what? To Stone.
Assisted by number three.
Chip to Torres. Looking from the corner. Nice tip of the pass. Trying to go to Hornquist. Gets in, and he'll look over his options. A lightning-like glove save. Pass attempt to Stone. Ottawa's up the wing settling things. Not a free puck now. Pitching this one to Hagelin. And he steps in. The Senators organizing back in their own end. Slid to MacArthur. Around through the corner. The Penguins, in their own end, in possession. Fires! Puck covered, whistle blown.
Fleury's going to be able to make that save all day. His positioning is perfect. It's not a difficult scoring chance.
Just over 3 minutes on the clock in the second. Do you think the ice is tilted in this one? Players are tumbling head over heels into the boards. Pittsburgh's got a face-off win. Luck ahead from the defensive zone. He gains the zone. Drill. Great glove save. And he holds on.
Ottawa's goaltending has been solid all year. When you look back at that last huge save, you know why.
The Senators with a clean win on the draw. In the defensive zone, making headway. Goes back deep for it. Gains the zone. That one blocked. Puck covered, whistle blown.
Been a long time since this wasn't the garden variety stop for a goalie. Down in the butterfly, turned aside.
The Senators win that faceoff. Take it away. Directing that one to Cole. Let's go. His shot. He scores.
Cole's quick flick of the wrist put this puck in from the high slot.
Anderson's all but beaten from the moment the puck gets to the shooter's stick, but look at the effort, Enzo. He never gives up on the play trying to make the glove stop.
The Penguins have built a tremendous lead and also built some wonderful confidence. What will they say in the second intermission? Probably not much. They've got the draw. Gets across, looks over his options. He throws it there. Outstanding save with a glove.
What a glove save. Seems like we've had a lot of this going on after a couple of the last whistles. Wouldn't be surprised if somebody's looking to dance in the future.
With one big punch. How did you score that one?
Dead even, Doc. Those are the type of fights that you really enjoy.
Sometimes it feels like you're punching the wind, but when you're down this much, you have to try and change something.
Got a defensive zone win. He's got it, but can he shovel it out of there? He's got that pass at the point. Lightning-like save off the one-timer. Let's go, Arister. The second period has been played, and that's the fun part. We now look forward to the third. We turn now to the shots on goal at the end of 2:34 for the Penguins and 14 for the Senators. Anderson's had a difficult contest, and here is an example of that. For now, he gets a rest. So do we as we head to break. Third period about to begin. The rear view mirror will help us with the first two, and so will Edza.
Pittsburgh's up, Doc, here with a pretty solid lead, but they know that their opponent's going to come after them. So let's see how they play it. Will they be defensive first or look to add to the lead that they have?
We are underway here in the third period. Anything can happen, but it's a tall order ahead for one team. Passing one off now to Ryan. Moved along and in. In front! Outstanding save. What magic to even get the shot away.
With this puck being so close to net, this is all a reactionary save.
I don't know how the shooter can do much more than that. The goaltender made an excellent save on a great bid for goal.
The Senators prevailing on the faceoff. Oh, stick save. The Penguins start the rush up ice. Fires! Score! He's got his second of the game.
It's not necessarily how hard you shoot it, but where you shoot it. And that was perfectly placed.
Hammond's only able to move so quickly. What a shot.
Pittsburgh's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. The Penguins get it off the faceoff. Good job with the stick. Up the wing, making some headway. And it's a good pickup. The Penguins wheel one ahead up the wing. Hammers one. He scores!
Goaltender had no chance with that wicked shot.
Hammond's only chance was this hit him. He couldn't even react.
Pittsburgh's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play. Turn to shot on net. Part of generating an offense, little pass off from the goal. Gains the zone. breakaway, score! He's got his second.
Well, he can't get his pad down quick enough to make this stop. Really good shot, as you mentioned, Eddie. I think that's one he should probably stop.
Pittsburgh's goal has built an even bigger lead. We're in the third period. For the opposition, at least that is fortunate. The Senators with a center ice faceoff win.
Sidney Crosby assisted by number 58.
And the pickup. Propelled to Malkin. Looking to Hagelin.
4 minutes, 10 seconds.
Shoots. Glove.
Oh, the hands are quicker than the glove. Great save.
The Senators with a face-off win. The battle for the puck, and he can't get free. Ottawa's up the wing, setting things up. On to Brassard. Gathered up again by Hagelin. Hanging on to it up the wing. The puck is fielded now. That shot came from right in front.
Seems like he was in too tight on the goaltender.
Shot! Oh, deflected away. Moving it to Brassard. Now it's directed to Wingles. Terrific interception. Laid on to Brassard. Malkin's looking to make a play from his own end towards center. Has it back deep. Pitching it to Phaneuf. Puck is thrown to Pageau. Ottawa's carrying on up the wing. Oh, he had a great chance to shoot there, and he did, but it was answered by the glove. Gets in. What'll he do? Shoots one. Turned away. Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a face-off right near.
Hammond's looking around, wondering where everybody else is, but he had to make a save on an odd man rush.
Good clean win, and he'll cover.
The shooter thought he'd made a pretty good shot here, but the goaltender's in good shape. He makes the stop, and he's able to deny the shooter on what he thought was an excellent chance.
Good clean win on the draw. Clean of the game. What a performance.
Thinking about taking a wrist shot, it's all about weight transfer. Transferring your weight from your back foot to your front foot when you're shooting that puck. That's exactly what happened there.
Pittsburgh's goal has taken them to an even larger lead on a night that they have had the offense going. Third period of play.
By number 13.
Gets in. What'll he do?
By number 58, Christopher Letang.
Chipped. Wonderful save. That's turned aside. And a whistle.
Pretty routine stop. You can see why everybody learns the butterfly when they're a young kid. Takes away the bottom of the net.
The Senators with a clean win on the draw. Oh, great cut. Ottawa's in possession as they move up the wing. Let's it go. They score! They finally answer.
Stone's slap shot had some heat on it.
Oh, he's trying to be aggressive, though. He just can't get out there quick enough to stop this shot.
Ottawa's gotten one. They still trail by a whopping score. There's not a lot of time left in the game, but maybe they can fine-tune a few things for next time. Nicely into the zone. Flings it. Oh, what a glove he's got there. And he freezes for the whistle.
Time of the goal, 12 minutes, 12 seconds.
Pittsburgh's got it again. Point blast! Ottawa's in control as they travel up the wing. Knocked it away with the stick. Taken up near the boards by Kessel. From the outside. Ottawa's in possession in their own end. Makes that play deep. Snapping a pass to Kessel. To Touris. Good intercept. Trying to go to Kessel.
The puck loose now picked up.
Up the wing, still with possession and with hope. The Penguins in their own end controlling the play. Still has control up the wing.
Good poke check by Erik Karlsson.
Puck controlled by Cole. Patted away. And another save.
That second save was textbook.
Pass attempt to Burrows. Shoots. Save. One comes to him behind the net. Held there for a faceoff coming up next.
Well, the shooter's pretty disappointed, guys. He delivered that puck quickly. It was accurate, yet the goaltender was just better than him on the wrist shot.
Good job on the draw. The Penguins look to make a difference up the wing. Boy, what reaction. He's got it again. Good work by Broussard. A long game and the clock bleeds down to the final minute of regulation. Slid to Cullen. Wonderful wrist shot. 47 on the clock. Taken toward the neutral zone. Pitching this one to Hoffman. Shoots. Terrific shot, but a great point-blank save.
The goalie makes himself look big.
Onside. Lets it go. And a good job in the goal crease. Directing that one to Kunitz. Offensive possession here. Fires. Great stick save. And he steps across the line. Enormous hit.
I saw him coming just at the last minute. He's able to spin off, but that's a big hit.
The game is over.
I know what that's like, Doc, being on the end of some bad game, some bad efforts. I'm not looking forward to practice tomorrow.
The playoffs continue with our next game. We hope you'll look forward to that one as much as we are. Meanwhile, for this one tonight, for Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good night.